Hello everyone and welcome back to Cities by Steven. You're talking to Steven. Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, please hit that subscribe button. Get that bell notification on too, so you don't miss out on a video. Welcome back to the town of Walsenberg in Orton County on our map for Prairie. So welcome back to the town. Last episode we started building up this small town, and I'm really pleased with how it's turning out. I think it's a lot of fun. I really like making these small towns in these builds. You know, building the downtown core is a lot of fun and whatnot. You only get one, usually, depending on your theme. But in this series, we only got one downtown, but there's so many small towns that we can make. And I like doing small towns because, you know, there's so many little nuances that you can do that make a small town, cute and unique and whatnot. And I think we're doing a good job at this. So I've done a few changes. It's only been about 15 minutes in my time since the last episode. So I just kind of went around, you know, adjusted a couple smaller things. So again, I don't see your comments until the end of the week usually for these videos. So if you have left a comment on last week's video and you really want to see a change or something added into this town, you'll see it next week because just that's the way my recording schedule is. So let's hop out and take a look around the little teeny town that we have. So I moved the cemetery over to the top of this hill. I also moved the fire station, which I'm actually just gonna move again because I'm realizing now that we should probably put it somewhere else. We're just gonna place it here for now. Although that's part of the older town. That's fine. It's fine. So I've added in some trees. I've adjusted some paths, tweaked some things. I've added in, for example, these tree line paths. I think they work really nicely, or tree-lined roads, with parking as well. So, there's that. I've added some houses right through here, just being a little bit particular with how the waterfront looks. Mainly because I wanted to save a bit of time in today's episode. And why are we doing that? Well, we're going to get a metro in. It's been a little while since we've done metro, and originally we had a plan to get a metro out this way. So now that we have the original town grid through here, what I want to do to boost, you know, people moving out here and whatnot, is plan out how the metro is going to run through the town. And why do I want to do this in today's video and not in tomorrow's video? Well, the right-of-way of the metro line is going to be a significant hindrance on our future development. You know, not really a hindrance, but a playful challenge, if you will. So we're gonna get a metro station, and we're gonna make sure that the metro is now ground level since we've left the downtown peninsula of this area. Everything else is going to be a ground level metro. So that's what we're going to do. Right now we have a metro running around right here. It's going to cross the river. And once we get into here, we're going to start having to talk about some other things. So before we get going on that, I want to get some zoning happening so that we have some growth while we're kind of doing some other stuff. And I've noticed that our budget is kind of fluctuating. So if we have time today, I'm going to add in some things in Orton County or in Minerals so that we raise our profit here. Definitely going to take a look at this at the end of today's video because it does seem to be fluctuating. I think it's something to do with the power as well with our dam. Whoa, all the way out over here. Fluctuating. Maybe that's kind of putting a damper on some things. Our college is also pretty expensive. So that could also be it. Yeah, it's definitely the college. Mainly because looks like we have so much sports happening. Maybe we can turn off this free lunch. But we're about to get to the next level and that'll help out the boost. So that's definitely why we see that fluctuation. So hopefully we can, our budget will hold on for the episode. Okay, so back over here. This whole area is gonna be residential right through here. We're going to turn off zoning along this road because this is a main road. I don't really want zoning on that. I think zoning can start to happen along this side, but along here I want it to be more like a highway kind of vibe. So in order to kind of encourage that, what we're going to do is we're going to take the highway speed of 100, though I don't think it's going to be 100. We're going to put it down to 60. Oh, whoa. Whoops. Let's put that back to 100, and then 60, I just want to drag it about here. Now this is kilometers per hour. This is a Canadian themed city, so usually you'll see a sign right about here, you know, slow down 60, but the rest of it I don't mind it being 100, and the 100 goes all the way up to the roundabout. So Yeah, pretty good. It works. With this beautiful bridge here, too. I think we said it was a provincially funded bridge. So let's turn off the zoning through here. An interesting kind of terrain work we got going on as well. I think we'll just smooth some of this out. It's right here. Turn it up a bit more. There we go. It's going to be helpful for how we build up in this area. And we might as well do this whole town. And oh yes, this is why I originally was planning at the waterfront as well for the video, because I want to make sure that we have removed some of the hitbox texture that we see with some of the houses. So we're going over here, but you know, sometimes they're a little squared off when really it should look a little bit more natural. So, you know, just going back and kind of doing some simple work like that can really go a long way. Okay, let's turn this down to here, and we'll just do a bit of trees around these houses just to kind of help for now with kind of the edging around the town. Really adds in that last bit of detail. All right, so there's a couple things we want to do, and that, like I said, is going to be the zoning. So this is quite a large area to just kind of block zone, but I think we'll probably be fine with this. I was thinking maybe we could get a path connection through here, and it'll be right in this section. So we'll just do a really simple, really basic, what am I doing? Holy cow. Zoo path with decorations this time. And we'll just go right here like that. Ta-da. And then I'm gonna grab this node, and we're gonna move it right in front of the school. I'm gonna pull this right back and then re-add it in. And hopefully the zoning doesn't go too crazy with everything that we just did. But looks like we're good. Let's just pull this down. And then let's change the tree to a young linden, which I really like. They look like just, you know, newly planted trees. So I really like adding them in. Okay, so that's gonna really fill in. It's a prime location. Let's throw it down to one speed for now. And then I wanna get a park in here, which is something that we didn't do last time. So we'll get a playground right beside the school. I think that could work. Could go for a more simple park. Let's do this. It has a dirt path. I wonder if we could sneak a connection in right here. Let's do that. Let's take out these trees. And we'll turn it into a dirt path, but I think we'll start off with a concrete path. Oh, autosave. And we'll come right down to here. And we'll just do a bit of a freeform kind of path. And we'll connect up, but not actually connect onto the node. I'm going to slide it in with move it. That way we don't get any weird jankiness that sometimes happens. But then we'll connect up this with dirt paths, and again we're not going to connect them up directly because you can get some funky nodes like that. That's actually not too bad. We got pretty lucky on that one, but just to stick with kind of how I do things. What the heck, where'd it go? It's right there, it's hidden apparently. Weird. Weird, weird, weird. Okay, there we go. And then I'll just move this one in. Okay, fantastic. And I see that there's a bit of zoning issue. So just like last on Monday's episode, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna turn this one into a bit more of a stronger path that allows us to do some of that concrete work. And there we go. We've kind of made a bit of a park in this area alongside it. So we have this spot available. Now I did say maybe we could get a pool out over here, but you know, this park looks really nice in here. It's not gonna really fit anymore. I'm sure we could kind of squeeze it in, but I'm not gonna really do that. But you know, we could always add in something nice. We could go with a dog park, though. I think I'd prefer a dog park in a bit more of a, you know, nicer area, but you know, not right there, but perhaps over here could be good, right beside the trail. although we're close to the trees. So we're gonna add the dog park in right here, and we're gonna name it Kevin's Park. Kevin's the Kevin Dog Park. Kevin is my dog, and Mark suggested that we make a park and name it after my dog. So, I forget what it exactly was. Sorry, Mark, but Kevin's Fun Dog Park or something like along this line. Dog Park. Okay, there we go. Kevin's Fun Dog Park, and we'll get a couple of these larger trees. Oops, wrong tree type. Along the road here, and then we're gonna get a path connection which leads into this hiking trail, so it kind of works out. Okay, there we go. So I think I'll leave this area open then. Maybe we can get something in there in the future. It's a great location, so that is good. Now let's just do some more big zoning. We'll do this. That works. Don't mind these smaller ones necessarily. There we go. Let's get that one, and we can get a smaller house right there. And then that works. Okay, so then we're going to continue this kind of mass zoning, and then we'll move into the metro. So let's go right into here, and let's turn our guidelines on. And I think we can go right about there, and maybe we can just move it right down like that. I think that'll be fine. Let's say this wasn't planned, but people do walk across here, so I'm gonna get a dirt path. Kind of shows like a piece of property that people walk across. It wasn't planned. I think that works pretty nicely, and I think we can probably shrink this down a touch. And then why don't we bring a path from about here right down as well, beside the dog park. Sure, people from this side of town will cut through, kind of thing. Okay, so that works out really nicely. Let's get a couple more of these large trees right here. I think that works for now. That's still kind of nice and in the clear. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. And then we'll get all this zoned up. Same thing here. I think we can probably leave. No, it's okay. I think that's fine if we do that. And then right along here, I want to zone up with residential, but maybe we just go right to about here. And we'll grab this, bring this right across. We won't connect it up. It'll just be a pedestrian connection like that. And we can get some nice, simple housing connections behind here. It'd be pretty loud with the fire station, so I'm actually gonna move this fire station. I can't find a spot I like for it. So maybe we move it down onto this side for now and we just leave it. But that should be good. And then now we get a nice set of zoning, a nice clean zone right through here for residential. Let's do this. And we'll get a bit more commercial. See how that works out. Okay. I think this is also prime commercial land. And we'll upgrade this road to that. And, oh, actually, I think I might want to upgrade this to a larger road. I think we'll come back to this momentarily. Okay, so we got a bunch of zoning ready to go. Don't really see too much more that I have necessarily plans for, except for right in here. Again, right beside the fire station. I can never run away from this thing. Okay, there we go. We'll let it all come in, and let's talk about the metro. So I have already the metro station planned out. This is a station that I got from the workshop. It kind of looks like the original metro stations. So I'm comfortable using these. It doesn't seem like I'm pushing too far out of the guise of city skylines. So I think the using these ones from the workshop is fantastic. So this is what they're called, Vanilla Ground Bypass Station by Kluss. So if you want to download them on the workshop, go ahead. They look really nice. I've never used them, so this is my first time using them. So this is what I want to use. I want to use that one. I'm going to just delete it really quickly. So let's find kind of where we want to get this metro through here. So here's the metro line. It goes right into Fort Prairie Station. We're going to curve it somehow. Let's check the topography. I think we can probably curve it right out through here. Let's find its landing spot. I think if we clear these trees, I think right in here is probably our best bet. That's pretty smooth. Looks really bumpy, but it's pretty good. I think we'll choose this height. And we need to kind of get it across here, right? So I think what we'll do is we'll curve it underneath. We got it right here. So let's kind of line this up just like that. I think that's probably a good line for us to kind of start with, at least. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go into bridge. We're going to go right across in a straight line to about here. And this is where we're going to go into tunnel. And this is where I need to switch views to this one. Yeah, okay, never mind. We're going to need to delete this part first. Okay, back to this tunnel mode. Yes, we are in tunnel mode, it seems. Looks good to me. We'll play with it. And then we'll go into curve. And I think this is about right. So we'll connect that up. Looks like it's a bit wavy. Okay, well, let's grab this node. Let's set it to the same height as the station. That looks funny to me still. Let's lower the node. Here, so let's grab this node, and then we'll grab this node. And then we'll just lower it to the ground. Yeah, that's about the height that I want it. So now let's go into network multi-tool. We'll grab the slope mode. We'll go there and we'll slope it right to... you know what? I think we might need to work on this node first. So I want it to be at a height that looks nice and everything. So let's grab that one, grab this one. Why isn't it lowering? Is it a tree? It's a tree. So I think to get it to look realistic, I think we might need to remove a couple nodes. I'm just going to push that one out of the way. And then this guy, we're going to extend out to about here and raise it up a little bit. And if we're looking at this in here, I think that looks pretty smooth from this angle. Once it's underground, I personally don't really mind what happens to it. So let's remove a node, and then let's straighten it all out. And now we're gonna do a smooth slope. And when you're doing stuff like this, definitely recommend, oh, I guess we can go right to here. Definitely recommend playing it with the game paused. Oh, no way. That is incredible. Oh my gosh, zero. So it just stays flat the entire time, underground, and then we just emerge above the water here. Oh, we're pretty low. Okay, never mind. I should have checked the bridge first, right? That's probably what I should have done. Probably. Okay, so we're just gonna raise it up. Oh. Undo. Go. Make sure we grab all of these ones. Let's raise it up to about here. Now, is this river navigable? We have a bunch of bridges already. I think it's probably fine. Can a boat get underneath that? Probably not at high in the high season like we are right now, but I think it's probably good. Let's just raise it up just a touch more. Okay, I'm gonna bring this one in to about there. Yeah, and that means we're gonna have to reshift everything around a little bit, so apologies for that. So here we go, move it. Extend this one out. Does that look appropriate? Don't we need to raise it up? Does that look okay? Minus the trees everywhere? Let's shrink this down. There we go. Let's get rid of that one. Proper tree anarchy is on. Of course it is. And then now we can redo that slope from here to here. Still not too shabby. All right, so here we go. That's pretty good. I wonder what happens if I remove a node on the bridge, because I really like the idea of having this look like a bit different. So remove node. Let's try that one more time. Nice. So that one's pretty long. Then we can get this one to be pretty long itself. Yeah, I think I like this. And what if I just grab these three and then we just move it over like this so that the long bridge is right in the middle of the river here like that. And then we go into upgrade to, yep, this right here. Turn off that, turn off this, and, oh, I guess we should probably select the metro. We'll go into elevated, upgrade, just like that. Fantastic, so we have this really large metro bridge. I suspect that boats would be able to get underneath here at a normal tide, or normal, not tide. We're playing with this game with the theme that it's in the spring, since that's when we started it. So there's lots more water than normal because of the spring melt. I think that's probably fine. Now my biggest worry is how we're gonna get the station in here with this kind of the slope that we've kind of got ourselves pinned to a little bit. But that's okay. Let's talk about the station. So the station, I want to get the bypass station. And we want it on a bit of an angle here. So I think what we'll do is just grab any road will do. And I'm just going to plan out a couple of options here. So let's go with, so that's one snap, two, three, four. Bring this one right over like that. And then we'll try one, two, three, four from this side. Okay, and then we'll see if that'll actually fit. Yeah, it does. It's actually pretty good. I think we're gonna need to do some small adjustments, but I wanna make sure that from the left side of the station, so on the left side of your screen here, that there's at least one train length away. Now, I actually don't really like that angle. I might actually curve it a little bit. I want it to be curved a little better here. But with this way, this was almost the shortest length that we could get. I might actually pull it over. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. We're gonna pull it over like this. Okay, and then I'm gonna bring it right across so that it's at its shortest point across the river. Almost there. But I think that's about where I want it. Yeah, and then we'll just need to adjust the tunnel a little bit. So give me a second with that. I need to go into here, tunnel, there we go. And we'll just select just nodes because that will be helpful. Okay, I'll play with it off camera to make it look nice. But yeah, this is a much better angle for what I actually want to use it for. But with the hill here, we might need to move some things around a little bit. So, you know, this is a pretty big mass. This is a pretty massive project here. So let's grab this node here. Make sure we're just grabbing this node. I think we are. Yep. And then I'm going to say get to terrain height. Here we go. So that's the terrain height that I want. So let's grab that. And actually, I think... Yeah, no, that's going to be fine. And then we're going to grab this. And we're just going to try and just take off a bit of this hill here. There we go. We're just going to now increase the size. And we're just going to level this all, this whole area out, because this is a pretty massive project here. But I'm not going to, see this terrain line? I'm going to leave that terrain line. And then I also don't mind how this side is bigger, a bit taller. So now let's grab these nodes. Set them all to the same height. That's fine. Okay. So let's plan out that metro station again. And I really want it pretty much at the same kind of angle as we've already selected. So 1, 2, 3, 4, about there. Bring it right up to about that point. And yeah, this hill is kind of the issue. Ooh, look at this. All right, well, that's okay. We'll get the station in. I think we can just kind of wing it a little bit. So again, I want to make sure that on the right side of your screen now that there's enough space so that a train can theoretically fit. So let's plop that down right about there. There we go. And then I'm going to grab the nodes and buildings. I'm going to just select all of these. And I want to say get to this height. There we go. I can delete that. I can delete this. And we're going to need a road on the other side as well. So we'll have to look out for that momentarily. Looks like we actually needed this height. And that's actually a little bit better for our situation. So again, I'm still kind of keeping that relative zone that terrain height was at. But I'm going to extend that out to about right there. And there we go. So we got our metro in here. Ta-da. And let's just connect it up. Okay, let's just go with a bit of a curve. I guess we're slightly off. That's okay. You know what? Let's just do a straight one. Just like that. Because we're going to need to do a couple of minor adjustments anyways. Like the slope from here to here. And I actually don't mind at all if it's elevated, because it looks just a little nicer. There we go. Yeah, I like the railings and whatnot. So I think that actually looks pretty cool. All right, so it is slightly off. So let's just do a quick couple adjustments on some of these nodes, especially this one. There we go, that's pretty good. And then now, we're coming through, the tunnel emerges, ta-da, I'll fix the tunnel, don't worry. And we slide right through here. And here we go, in the station. And it's a bypass station, because eventually this will go out to the airport, and I think we can get an express metro, so I like the idea of having a bypass station. So now, I want this one to go out this way. But we have a road in the way, and it's just conveniently placed that we have a hill right there. So why don't we pretty much just go ground level from here, and we'll go curve, we'll slide right underneath the intersection here, like that. And I'm gonna grab that, this. There's one more node I need to select. That's the one. Set it to the same height as that. And then we have ourselves a bit of the beginnings of a trench. I really like that kind of idea here. So let's get this road upgraded. So you notice how we have four lanes here. I want to continue that theme, but we're going to upgrade the road size now. So let's go with just the basic concrete road. Let's go no parking though. It's going to be elevated to about there. And then we have an intersection right here. And I think we're going to also go with a bit of a bigger road here, but we're going to go with this one. Elevated, and then same thing here, bring this right across, elevated, just like that. So we are going to need to do a couple adjustments here. We're going to grab this intersection, then going to just scooch it down. Actually, you know what, no, let's leave it at the same height that it's at. Let's raise it up a touch. Let's grab this node, and that's actually where I want it. I want it right underneath this. Okay, then let's grab this node. We'll readjust. That's a pretty fine curve. I don't mind that at all. And we'll just readjust that as well. And then this is the curve I'm worried about now. It's how this slope is kind of working. Down into here. Let's do that. There we go. I actually think maybe if we go to ground level, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Let's check it out though, and we'll see. Yeah, you know what? I think it's probably better. And I almost want to just upgrade this whole thing to here because we already planned for it to be that size. And we did plan for this one as well, but I think I'll leave it as a smaller kind of road size. So because there's a change from an elevated to a ground height, this node is a bit funky. So if you just go into node controller and you slope it, it tends to look a lot nicer. And then you can always just do a bit of this. And you can always do a filler as well, which is with Alt. And you hold Alt down on the intersection marking tool. And then you can actually just go to pavement. And there you go. Fill it in. And there we go. It looks a lot nicer, doesn't it? And then we'll just grab this and we'll continue this upgrade all the way out to here. We could upgrade this side, but we're not going to. Instead, what we're going to do is we're going to then slope this road from here to here, and we'll see what that gives us. Nice. Look how smooth that is from this side. That's fantastic. Holy moly, except for that truck in there. And then here's the beginnings of a rail trench, a metro rail trench that doesn't have to necessarily run forever, but it's going to run as a trench through here. So here we go. We're just going to curve it out pretty much at, seems to be at the exact length of where this kind of bump out ends, and we'll bring it out right to there, and we'll call it a day with the metro. And I'm just going to grab all these nodes. Oops, I was wondering, I thought I was going to move it there. Make sure we're just grabbing that one node. There we go. I'm going to grab them all. Just nodes, probably a bit easier if I just do it this way. And then let's set it to the same height as that. There we go. We have a nice curved rail trench through here. I think there's just a couple adjustments that we can make, particularly around this node here. There we go. And we curve all the way out to here. And next thing you know, we'll be in Winslow and at the airport. So we can then grab our metro line here. So that is the metro line that is called. Oh, I guess the name's changed. Well, this is the General Hawkins line. Whoa. After Lee Hawkins, the YouTuber, City Skylines YouTuber. I think that suggestion came from JMWZ, and I forget what the name is for the downtown university line. So apologies for that, but let's just move this stop all the way out to here. Ta-da! And then we're going to then add in stops back in Fort Prairie Station. And since we've upgraded this, I'm going to upgrade the amount of people that the amount of trains on this line to 3. I think 3 is going to be fine for now, and we'll see if we need to revise it. So that is fantastic that we have that in place. Now we need a couple. Now is when the work really starts, I guess. So integrating that into this old town that we kind of have planned out. So there's a couple more things we need to do. We need to slope this properly. 6.8%. Trucks definitely wouldn't use that. Slope that properly. That's fine. And we already sloped the other one. I think we need to slope this to here. And then we need to slope from there to here. There we go. Let's go into our smoothing tool and let's just smooth out this terrain here because it is a little funky because of all the changes that we've been making. It's particularly around here. I've noticed that death care is quite an issue out in this area, which is not something I was particularly expecting, to be honest with you. Okay, I'm sure we could sneak a path underneath there. That would be interesting. So I think we could add in another crematorium even to help out with all of this. I think could slide it right in here. I think that might help remove some of the funkiness as well of that corner. So let's do that. And then we have this street here, which should probably be upgraded. So let's upgrade it to this one. Yeah, there we go. And then we have a bunch of access roads with 4 lanes. This one doesn't necessarily need to be that. I think we can just leave it as so. This one is good. I think this one should almost be a barrier, like a larger road, like this one. Whoops. Come on. There we go. I think that works out a little bit better. And perhaps we even raise this node up a little bit like that. And we'll just come back and we'll do these slopes again. Okay, and that means we need to do this terrain again. And that's okay. Grab this building and just make sure that it's at the height of that node. There we go. And then I'm just going to grab a tree if I can just to reset everything. Okay. So we need water out this way. That's okay. We need to connect this road up. That is definitely a priority. So let's go with that. I think we'll start off with just a normal road and we'll upgrade it right away to a asymmetrical road. But I like to do just a basic road first sometimes. Just like that. I think that should be fine. Let's go into here, and TMPE is the term. There we go. Just doing some of this, and we'll go into node controller as well right here, and I would really like it if we could expand this node to about 15, and we'll square it as well. Okay, looks nice. Looks very nice indeed. Ooh. I think I noticed that. Okay, fantastic. Now let's connect up these roads. So we'll just go with normal roads to start off with. Let's bring this guy right down just for now. And then we'll connect this one up at a nice non-bending angle here. Just like that. And you can probably connect these up. Don't necessarily mind. I think we could get some interesting road work through here. And I think this allows us to actually upgrade this whole section to be 4 lanes. Like that. Don't mind keeping this one more quiet. Okay, so that means we need to go back into TMPE and do some of this. Some of that. Some of this, and some of that action. There we go. All right. So that's a pretty basic grid connection here. I think we can probably bring another road down on this side. So let's grab just a normal road now. I think we're done with the 4-lane roads for the time being. Bring it right up to here, And then I'm going to have a one-lane, one-way road. No parking. That is going to... Let's actually bring this more down to about there. And this one's just going to be a little slip lane right into here. Let's grab the segment. Just like that. I think that's probably acceptable. And why is this necessary? Well, it's not, but I think it would be interesting to kind of add in. I don't think it's really important at all. I don't think we need to. Just Control S. But I do think that if this becomes quite a popular park, I think like having people kind of just go right through there and avoid this corner at all costs would be good, because this is the first or last intersection of this town. So I think having that extra slip lane might just prove to be helpful, and it adds a bit of a je ne sais quoi to the town, you know? Okay, so let's grab this guy. This guy can continue a bit farther, and let's bring this one out there, and we'll try and connect it up right about there. Although I do like, maybe not right there. Maybe we just go about double the length, and we'll go, this is kind of the entrance into Babcock Point, so maybe we don't have any roads on this side, and we have this be the entrance onto Babcock Point. Yeah, that could work out. And why don't we delete this road then, and we'll try again from about here. And I think, so we're gonna have an entrance on this side. I think maybe we have a bit more of like a parking entrance over here. So we'll bring it out a bit farther like that. And then we'll do a bit of a curve like that. And then we'll just bring it out straight to about there. And I think that's probably fine. So that means we have about this much space for zoning options. I think we're good like that. I think this would be interesting to get a crosswalk right there. So what if we... you know what? No, let's leave it at that. We'll get pedestrian area. We could do something like this. No. Anything would be right here, I think, would be the area where I would want that road. And right about here, delete that. Right about here, yeah, we'll use that node, that's fine. We'll get this one out to about there. Bring this down and over here, and then we'll just get a couple more suburbs through this little zone. Don't like that, but I think we'll live with it. Yeah, this is really nice. It's this part of town. And we'll get a bit of a curved kind of road like that, and then we'll connect it up pretty straight on. Just clean that curve up. I think that's fun. It's a fun grid. Okay. Yeah, I like that. Kind of keep the terrain size. We've shaped this park. We've given ourselves some nice options here. Yeah, okay. Let's get water to the station so that we can actually see people start to use it. And we'll bring some into the park here as well. All right, now the tricky part is, I think, going to be trying to get people on this side over here, right? So let's try and get a road down over there first. Let's just bring this through like that. There we go. Delete that and that. And here we go. I'm going to grab these three nodes, set it to the same height as that. Okay, so we're good there. This is equal as well. And now we need to connect it up somehow to here. Let's check out the topography really quickly. It's always good to check out. Yeah, we're not that far off. We could try and just go right to it like that. And then let's see if we can bring this one over. We can kind of curve this a little bit. Over like that. Yeah, I don't really mind that. A bit farther so this is a bit cleaner. Yep, that looks pretty nice. All right, so let's go into node controller here and we'll square the node, and I'll just grab this point here if I can, bring that over like that. And it looks like there's an issue with the crosswalks here, because I definitely want crosswalks here. Looks like something's happening, so I think we probably do have crosswalks. So I think we'll leave it. Let's see. Yeah, people are walking across. Okay, so it's just a little glitch. That's great. Okay, so we got this in place now. Let's get some zoning in. We'll look at potentially getting a high school as well. I think the high school is going to be better over on this side, so maybe we save the high school for tomorrow or Friday's video. So I know at the beginning of the week I said that we were going to be doing multiple small towns, but I guess we're only really doing this town. That's okay. It's a pretty cool town. Yeah, that's probably acceptable. And I think we'll leave that. I think right here we can have a road goes right across. Or maybe we should have brought that a bit closer. Yeah, probably. Let's go right about here. Get right behind the church there. And then why don't we upgrade to elevated like that? Let's grab this. We'll set it to the same height as that. And this one will also set to the same height. And then this one, we're going to need to do some sloping. So we'll go from here down to here. 4% is pretty steep, but we'll definitely have to watch it. Probably don't let trucks over here. All right. So there we go. We got some nice road networks planned. Let's check out that high school placement. Oh, after we do a bit of vast mass zoning. Okay, I think we can let that all come in first. So a high school, where would a high school be? Well, I think we're gonna put it in the newer part of the town, which is gonna be probably north of this road, or at least around this road. Right in here is probably a really good option for the high school. Yeah, honestly, right in this little block is pretty good, but it's pretty close to the main town. We could put it right near Babcock Point, which might be nice. Maybe we eliminate this block altogether. Slide it right in here. Could be nice. Okay. Still, it's pretty close to the river, though. Not really comfortable with that. Don't want to be too close to the station either. Keeps coming back to this zone right in here. So why don't we just lean into it? We'll put the high school in here. It can be an older high school. So let's grab, where is it? Holy cow. Here we go. And we'll go with this one. We're beside the police station. How about we put it right here? It seems to be a pretty heavily trafficked zone. So we slide that right there. And then we push this right across like that. There's a node right here. Let's just slide this node over like so. And then what we'll do is we'll put a crossing in with node controller. All right. And then I really like incorporating this path into my high school builds. So we'll do that. And then we'll just grab the high school and just scooch it right back like that. And now people will come right across and cut right through the high school itself. Lots of option for parking as well, but it is kind of running late in the video. So I want to make sure that we have enough time for everything. I think maybe we can get a couple little cul-de-sacs in here. I think that might be nice. Let's grab this. Yeah, right from here. Come right down. And, oh, I don't mind actually that being a grass road. I didn't mean for it to be a grass road, but that's okay. So we'll do that. And then we could even just bring this one right down like so. But that's City Hall. Don't necessarily love that idea. Could bring it right out to here. Not super, super close. Let's pause the game. Bring it to there. Bring it right up against that. That allows us to do the same thing here. And then let's go to this. Looks like the zoning didn't actually jump, which I'm very pleased about. Let's turn zoning off of this road here. Or actually, let's prioritize newer roads. Uh-oh. I'm not going to do anything on that side. Uh-oh. I don't want to mess with the zoning. Looks like I did, though. Perhaps it's because of that. Uh-oh. All right, well, we'll definitely see some changes to this. Yeah, you know what? Let's just call a mulligan on this whole situation. Because I really don't want that to mess up the main street. So we'll just get those cars to come back in here, and we can just get another simple, park or something like that. I don't really mind. We could get like a service building through here or something. We're just looking to see if we could get some extra housing in. And then right through here, I don't think we need another connection. So why don't we look at just getting a simple road right across from here. That works. And we'll prioritize older roads like so, right there. So hopefully that works out. And we'll try to get a pedestrian pathway right there to kind of fill that little corner. So we'll just do something simple with a concrete path for now, like that. Okay, so I think we're doing pretty good here. We got some more zoning through here, and we'll come back on Friday and we'll finish off this town, because I think the metro took a bit longer than I was anticipating it would take. Whoa. My game is going a bit slow. Sometimes after recording a couple episodes in a row, like I did for this week, that tends to happen. But, you know, we got the metro in. I think that's really good, really important. We got the high school in. And the last thing I want to do is a bus, because now we've got this in here, I think it's going to be convenient. So we're going to get a couple buses. So I think what we'll do is make this like a bit of a bus road. I was thinking about a station, maybe, but this one's going to run right down in front of the station here, and we're going to run it right down into the main town with two stops. And pretty much we're going to run it right back. But I think we might run it kind of up through this part of town. Or we could actually put it right here, or maybe even right here. Yeah, that works. And we'll run it right back. There we go. I noticed that I didn't delete this from last episode. So just a simple little loop like that through the town will really help circulate the people. We could even try and drag like a stop down to here and just have it come right back like that. That might be nice. And then we can have this stop right there. Yeah, I think that probably is fine. Again, it's not like ideal, but there we go. And we're gonna have another stop that goes from this metro station up to here, into our bus hub for the ore industry, and pretty much comes right back. So those are the two stops, buses that I really have planned for right now, but it's the end of the video, so we'll come back, we'll revise them another time, and yeah, you know, they look good. It's gonna be functional, it looks good. Got some commercial zoning along here, something fancy right in front, some more residential along the sides here, and I think Walsenberg is coming along pretty nicely indeed. Yeah, I really like this little town, it's a lot of fun. Alright, so, hope you enjoyed today's video, folks. I will talk to you in the next episode. Let's look at the shadows here for this town. I'm going to do something like this for the screenshot. Have a wonderful day. Talk to you soon. Peace out.